Today, I'm at the tippy top of a very tall mountain in North Carolina. I'm at this 3-floor A-frame cabin. It has these gorgeous million-dollar views right here behind me of these Smoky Mountains. And also the interior design is very unique. Definitely not what you expect to find at a cabin at the top of a mountain in North Carolina. So let's go and take a closer look. Welcome to this gorgeous mountaintop A-frame cabin that we're going to tour today. To get here, you're gonna drive about a mile or so up this very long and windy road. It's obviously quite steep to get all the way up here, but now we're gonna walk up the driveway and past my car. You'll get your first glimpse of the bottom floor, some stairs, and all of the deck space. We'll now walk up these stairs past the beautiful flowers to check out more of what is on the surrounding property and throughout the grounds. And so if we look up now, there's a bunch of paths that lead out into the garden. It's really peaceful just to walk around and explore. On the other side then, you have a fire pit waiting for you and this swinging bench. Now we'll focus on the exterior in particular. I love the blue paint job. It definitely makes the cabin stick out amongst the other cabins on top of this mountain. And like most A-frames, the windows in the front are very pivotal. And these windows, especially that unique design on top, definitely didn't disappoint. Next, I'll show off more of the exact location of this cabin on top of the mountain as I'm walking down that deck to take in more of these incredible views. If we zoom out even further, you can see that little blue speck in the middle of the frame is the A-frame, so we're about as high up as it gets. Now with this clip, it gives you a better idea of the overview of the land that we have here. As we kind of move around, you can see those different paths as they go throughout the garden. And if we slingshot around, you can see that smaller blue building is for storage. But overall, you have a nice chunk of land on top of this mountain. Finally, for those million-dollar views, this is the view straight off your deck, looking out into another one of the many mountain ranges here in the Smoky Mountains. Just everywhere you look from left to right, there are more peaks and valleys and just gorgeous backdrops like this. I was flying my drone just nonstop, but one of the best shots was around sunset as I was flying over one of the main roads here and the sky lit up like this. That will do it for the exterior, so we'll now head through this blue door to go on inside. We'll come into this entry hall now, and the first room we'll explore is right next to me. This is bedroom number 1 of 3. And you'll notice very quickly throughout this entire home, there is a lot of white and a lot of neutral colors. Right next to the bed though is a nightstand with some nice decoration, some flowers, a lamp. You then have a large closet against this one wall and then some storage space here. Directly connected then to the bedroom is this small bathroom. Not a ton of square footage here, but it has everything that you need. So overall, I found this bedroom to be quite comfortable. Let's now head up top to the main floor. The first room we'll enter into is your kitchen. I believe this space is recently renovated. You can definitely tell by all of these stainless steel appliances, starting first with your stovetop over here. Next to the stovetop then is your fridge and your freezer. Then actually above the stovetop, it says Bon Appetit, more on that later. Next to your coffee, then your microwave and a toaster oven. We'll ease out a bit now to go to the other side of the kitchen. You have a double sink, then a large Eiffel Tower, which can actually be used to put wine corks in. You'll notice a bunch of French and Paris references throughout the home. That's because the owner is French Canadian, and she described the interior design as French provincial decor. This kitchen definitely matches the rest of the home though very well. Let's continue to explore. The door on the left is the staircase down to the bottom floor. Straight ahead is storage, and that door on the right is actually a tea room. You can use this just to hang out and sip some tea, even though the owners told me they have now converted this into a new bedroom. Next up, we'll continue down this hallway and enter into this bathroom. It's the second bathroom and a little bit larger. It kind of feels like it belongs inside of a bed and breakfast in France to me. And over here is your shower with the curtain all rolled up. At the end of this hallway then is bedroom number 2 of 3. You have this huge bed that's pushed against this corner, all these flowers, and it's pretty bright and airy inside of here, even a chandelier up top. And then if we kind of go beyond the bed and hook left, you have another door here. This leads back outside to the gardens. Let's now go and check out the last space on this main floor. That is the living room and dining area. As you pan from left to right, it's a pretty wide open space, looking back towards the kitchen. As I do with all of my A-frame tours, we have to peer up top towards the ceiling. More on that later though. You then have a large sofa there. You can easily fit 4 or 5 people. If we take a step back, this is now looking out towards the deck. Over here is your dining table. You have 6 seats right here, very bright and white in European style. Then even over here on the sofa, these sofa cushions are black and white and have those neutral colors. Last but not least, in this living room space, if you go over to this corner and you open up the cabinets, you have a TV for entertainment. Let's now briefly head outside to the deck, as there's still a few things I want to show you. Let's now walk through the screen door though and come out to the main deck. You can tell it's quite spacious from this angle. You have 2 lounge chairs though and a coffee table, looking out at those magnificent views again. But close up, I also love this angle as well of all the windows, especially the A part up top. Let's now go to the other side of the deck. Still some empty space there. Maybe they'll add some more chairs or recliner options in the future. You kind of have this entertainment and chill out space over here on this section of the deck. You have a grill, and also against this wall, you have a large countertop space to prep some meals, but a great option to entertain if you're here with your family or a group. Finally, we are now back inside to check out the last space on this tour. That will be the loft up on the 3rd floor. So we're gonna go and walk up these stairs to get there. And this is the best view in the house. Just look at those 6 windows. You have all the wooden beams going across everywhere, the bright white paint job. It's views and architecture like this that made me fall in love with A-frames in the first place. This is why I tour so many of them. Your loft bedroom then awaits you. The interior design really matches with the rest of the home, especially the decorations here on the nightstand. This is a very cozy bedroom. This is where I ended up spending the night. Thanks for watching, guys. Be sure to give the video a thumbs up and make sure you're subscribed if you made it this far. My A-frame cabin playlist is linked out in the description. Thanks again for watching, and I'll see you next week for another Airbnb tour.